It was another beautiful day on Sodor, but there was trouble stirring up at the Dieselworks, as Diesel 10 was plotting another evil plan with Splatter, Dodge, and Professor Z. You three won't believe what I have overheard from earlier this morning.
What is it, boss?
That magical puffball lady is back! That means I can finally get my revenge on her and that blue puffball for dumping me in that barge of sludge years ago!
Oh yeah, I'm sure we can...
That'll go well.
What's that supposed to mean, Splodge?
Oh, nothing. It's just that every time, plan will fail again like always.
Oh really? Name one time where my plans have failed.
We could name 100 times your schemes have failed. What about the first time you tried to destroy Lady?
Or the time you tried to go to Steamworks?
Taking the steamy decorations at Christmas?
The missing engines mystery?
Stealing iron engine suits?
The mind control troublesome truck?
Trying to scrap Neo Jr.?
The buried treasure?
And who could forget the time you and Mr. Sneer tried to monitor Timothy's?
And what about the time I tried to conquer Earth with Mr. Sneer? Did you two dunderheads forget about that as well? Or is your memory that pathetically terrible?
Face it, Diesel Tunner. Every time you come up with an evil scheme, it always fails.
Well, Splodge, if you don't like the way I do things, then you can just leave!
Good, because you know what?
We quit!
Who needs you, Splodge? We can manage without you! Splatter and Dodge. As they made their way down the line, Splatter and Dodge were still grumbling about Diesel 10.
Stupid Crash 42, what an idiot!
I know. I mean, every time you destroy the steam engines, it always backfires and we get blamed.
Well, now that we no longer work for him, we better start looking for a new boss.
But who? We can't just pick any random engine. We need a specific sort of boss we can trust.
Yes. Someone who won't call us Splodge. Someone who had foiled Diesel 10's plans before. Someone like... You're thinking what I'm thinking, Dodge?
Looks like we've got a new boss, Splatter. Come on, let's see if Thomas wants to be our new boss.
Thomas was at the junction dropping off passengers when the two Diesels arrived. Thomas eyed the two engines with deep suspicion. He knew the trouble Splatter and Dodge had caused with Diesel 10 in the past, and knew that Lady was coming. Diesel 10 would want revenge, but since Splatter and Dodge weren't with Diesel 10, he decided to be nice.
Good morning, Splatter. Good morning, Dot. What would you both be doing here?
Oh, nothing much. Just taking a stroll down the line.
We are looking for a new boss to replace Diesel 10, since we are no longer work for him.
No longer work for Diesel 10? What happened?
Let's just say we got tired of his plans and backfiring and him blaming us. So we left his sign, and now we are looking for a new boss.
And what has this got to do with both of you doing here?
Well, we were wondering, should you be our new boss?
Thomas was surprised at such a request. He thought long and hard about this.
Well, I'll have to run this by the Fat Controller. But until then, my answer is yes?
Oh, thank you, Thomas.
We'll set to that. You will never regret it.
Just as Thomas was about to leave, Peter came out of the station and spoke to Thomas.
Thomas, the Fat Controller wants you to go to Natford and show Lady around the island. He'll arrange someone to look after Annie and Clarabel until you get back.
Thomas looked over towards Splatter and Dodge, and at once, both Diesels knew what he was going to ask.
Splatter, Dodge, can you both look after Annie and Clarabel until I get back later?
Yes, boss.
Right away, boss.
And soon, the arrangements were made. Thomas set off for Napford Station, and Splatter and Dodge gently buffered up to the old coaches. Splatter coupled up in front, and Dodge buffered up in back. And together, the two engines set off towards Farquhar Station. For the rest of the day, both engines looked after Thomas's trains and made friends with Percy, Toby, Mavis, Terrence, and Bert the Bus. Even Annie and Clarabel were impressed with the two shunters.
They are very kind, aren't they, Clarabel? They are indeed, Annie. They remind me of Thomas. Well, at least when he's not being cheeky or racing with Bertie.
Oh, stop it. You're making me a flattered blush.
Later that evening, Splatter and Dodge had dropped off Annie and Clarabel at the shunting yards and were making their way to Tidmouth Sheds, where they knew whether Thomas would accept them to become his diesel sidekicks or not. They began to hear the sound of pistons pounding the rails.
Dodge, can you hear popping?
Now that you mention it, I can hear it. And it could be golden. We passed back down the line.
Oh, kind of thing that sounds more like a tank engine.
Yeah, it sounds like two engines. In fact, it almost sounds like...
Before Dodge could finish, Lady and Thomas raced past the two Diesels, and not too far behind was Diesel 10. You're mine, Lady, and this time no one can stop me!
Splatter, Dodge, help!
All Splatter and Dodge could do was watch as the three engines raced into the distance. Then a horrifying realization hit the two Diesels.
Oh no!
What?
I know where that line leads to!
You made their headed toward the old viaduct? Yikes!
Come on! That bridge could collapse at any moment!
Revving their engines, Splatter and Dodge gave chase after Diesel 10. Meanwhile, Diesel 10 was still chasing after Thomas and Lady! You won't get away from me this time, Lady!
You'll never catch me, because the magic you've always refused to believe in will always get the better of you.
We shall see about that, right, Pinchy? Oh, Puffball! Pinchy's still hungry! And his prey won't get away this time!
I'll stay back!
Splatter and Dodge were panning up the line with every ounce of strength they had, until at last, they caught up with the three engines and slowly pulled up alongside Diesel 10.
You leave Thomas and Lady alone!
Never! You've made a big mistake trying to save these puffballs! Looks like I'll have to scrap you both as well! which is good, as Pinchy is now hungry for some backstabbers! The old viaduct loomed ahead, and it was already on the verge of collapsing.
Splatter, Dodge, what are you both doing?
Making sure you and Lady don't get hurt by that monster.
There's no way we can make it across now.
It's a risk worth taking.
Just keep going.
Did we make it?
We made it.
Well done, Splatter, and well done, Dodge.
Thank you, Bass.
Thank you.
Oh no. Stop! No! Not again! Squatch! Oh, you know, I really hate cruises. That evening at Tidman's Sheds, Thomas and the engines were congratulating Splatter and Dodge for saving Thomas and Lady and stopping Diesel 10.
Well done, Splatter and Dodge.
You saved my best friend!
What you did both was terrific!
Really useful, that's what I say.
Well, thank you, sir.
We did what we thought was right.
Well, what you both did was very brave, and in your reward, Thomas told me you had wanted to become his sidekick, and after careful consideration, I decided that you both are worthy of working for Thomas, as long as you both behave yourself for him.
Well, thank you, sir.
We'll be the best Deedles ever.
Very well, then. You'll start working for Thomas tomorrow.
And the Fat Controller left. The engine spent most of the night talking to Splatter and Dodge about their daring rescue until they all fell asleep, all except Splatter and Dodge.
You know, Dodge, this could be the start of a really useful friendship with these steam engines.
I'll be one to agree with that, Splatter. Well, it's time to get some sleep. We've got a busy first day working for a new boss. Good night, Splatter.
Indeed. Good night, Dad.
And both Diesels soon fell asleep, glad to finally be free of Diesel 10's tyranny. Nowadays, you can see Splatter and Dodge working hard as Thomas's Diesel sidekicks, shunting trucks and pulling Annie and Clarabel. They enjoy it! They have made good friends with all the engines of Sodor. While some say that Splatter and Dodge may be silly, and others say that they're annoying, everyone can agree that Splatter and Dodge will always be really useful engines.